Chai with Lucky. I do have Babu Mariam and of course Ashlyn Mobiru. And today we are looking at office politics. Banang. How do you survive? We have a people management consultant, Ashlyn. Amongst us, she's the expert when it comes to people. So how do we survive in a work environment that has lots of politics and remain doing our jobs and doing them good?
Okay. Office politics, which also sometimes people term as workplace politics,
right,
is a human behavior that involves interacting with people, which in there, in that interaction, there is power and authority that is exercised.
You're speaking too much English.
Maybe because I'm English. Okay. Yeah.
But that, I mean, that, you simplify everything.
Yeah,
yes.
To make it simplified is the interactions that people have in organizations differ. But how they say that there's a lot of politics in this office, it's because there's a lot of power and authority exercised, which somehow may be necessary, and sometimes it's not necessary.
In most cases,
it's not necessary.
But one thing
that's why
it
becomes office politics.
Let me tell you one thing why office politics has to be. There is no organization across the world that doesn't have office politics.
Yes.
So it is always there. The problem is the managers in these various organizations are the ones who don't know how to play with the dynamics of office politics.
They forget misuse. About the managers.
Yes.
They
me,
misuse.
There's misuse, yes. That's going to happen. Like she said, anywhere in the organization in the world, it's going to happen.
It's going to happen.
But you, as the person they employ, how are you going to survive in an environment that has too much politics? How do you penetrate through because you still want to work and maintain your job? I think that's what we should be looking at here.
Because first of all, if you join an organization, you join with your expertise, your experience,
whatever
it is that the organization has seen you deem fit to be part of that organization.
Right.
The moment you join an organization, most times people join in and they say, I'm going to do this, I'm going to ensure that I'm seen, I am able to perform. Then you enter an organization and people start saying, Tuakalaba, Ajakowa.
Right.
So you start also saying, why do I have to do
work so hard? Yes.
Let me leave it. Mm-hmm. And then and those that say, I'm not going to leave, I'm going to be me, are seen as the wiseacres, and then they are sidelined.
But you see, me, I think that when you enter an organization, leave alone, I'm going to be this, I'm going to be that, you first have to study the people. Because let me tell you, when you enter an organization, you will see where the politicians are. They'll be in cliques. They'll be associating more closely with one another.
Right.
So you have to be able, you have to have a sharp eye. Let me tell you, so whatever experience you bring or whatever, by the time they got you, they thought you were capable of working there. The issue is you will see those people. So you have to do a study. And it has to be a study that is not a very long study because
you have limited time.
You have limited time. You have limited time to know where to fall and how to fall there. Why you get
look, in most cases, while this politics is taking place, there's a lot of gossip that is going on. Do you be part of, don't you, or you distance yourself? That is a question that I would like to ask you. There is Lugambo going on, and we know Lugambo also comes with so many things. First of all, there's people will easily come to you if you also join in and be part of, but then it's still Lugambo. If it's really not your thing, should you still join in just so you fit in?
One thing people need to notice that when you join an organization and you are capable of doing what you need to do, some of these things, people come from out when they are used to being in Lugambo.
Right.
So they easily fit in and say, I'm going to identify myself
with
this type of people because they kind of relate with the way I work or with the way I want to get my way around things. And there are those who will not think that I need to be part of that. I just need to deliver.
Unfortunately, that Lugambo is not the way to play politics if you actually want to work in that organization. Because let me tell you, you already find when people have their, like I told you, their cliques. And let me tell you, unfortunately, and you'll agree with me, those that politics is mostly played by the upper management.
What because are they looking it's divide for? And rule,
no.
Isn't it?
That's fine. Workplace politics is about behavior, power, and authority.
But you see how it comes in is that these managers misuse their power. Definitely. So they are looking for favors, they are looking for people who can actually lick their toes literally, they are looking for people who can be timid even when you're not timid. So you have to know which managers are these. And let me tell you, me honestly speaking, I would avoid such people. I'm telling you, that's how I've been. That's
but
how
then,
I was.
You know, then, when you say, Mariam, when you avoid the lugambo or the gossip that goes on in the office, aren't you likely to miss out on some information, some stuff that is happening? For me, I say you be there, but you don't exactly partake.
Yeah, but if you don't partake,
like if Ashley has a group of people who have lugambo, and I also need information, sometimes you know who's going, because through those people, you know who's going to be promoted. You see where there is
then
space
they
for you to
listen rather than a contributor.
Now let me tell you something about, like you said, this politics in the workplace is brought about by the leaders.
Right.
Now one thing that leaders need to know is that power or powerlessness corrupts. The lack of power corrupts.
Right.
Then you also need to note that absolute power
also
corrupts absolutely.
Just corrupts.
So the thing is, the moment someone gets the power and you're not able to use it to work within the mission and vision of the company, then you're corrupt. That means you have gone to the absolute power.
And
but the lack of power again corrupts you, because then you start having those cliques signing with people. Because if you had power, that's why they say the powerlessness corrupts. If you had power, you can be able to know who falls where and how can I work with these various cliques to ensure that they deliver.
But most people are actually in positions they're not supposed to be.
That's the thing.
Because you're assuming,
because
if you're given power to be the leader of, first of all, you're not even supposed to exercise that power. Power is not how vocal you are.
Yeah.
Power is not for you to be heard. But
delivery.
Power is delivery.
And
in most cases,
yes.
And the people who do the work, unfortunately, are not the ones who are leading, right?
Exactly.
So if he knows he's not doing what he's supposed to be doing,
all the organizations I worked in had politics.
Of course, like you said,
but for me, my trick was one.
Right.
Number one, I knew what I was supposed to do. So I knew where to engage. And let me tell you where to engage, like you said, you know where to get the information. So if you know where to get the information that will help you to do your work, then you try to fit in there. But how do you fit in? It doesn't mean that you lick toes. Me, I don't lick toes.
One thing,
because when you lick toes, they step on you, they start making you do work that is not yours. They take you off track. And then when performance comes, let me tell you, performance review comes, you'll stand alone.
Alone, totally.
You'll stand alone because you are not doing your work, or because
you're assessed individually. So remember, you know, like she said, misuse of the power. So when you go deep in those things, me honestly, what I think I should advise people is that you just need to know who is in the power and what do I need from this person to do my job.
And so
this business of lugambo, let me tell you, in the long run, it's not sustainable. It's actually a downfall.
Wait a minute. There is doing lugambo, but are you doing your work? Because let's face it, you're at your workplace. These other relations that you have with other people are just relations.
But you're not.
You're there to deliver your work. Here is what I do. I do my work.
That's the thing.
And I do it extra.
But most people don't.
You know what I mean? Once you've done your work, regardless of what you do after that, it's very hard for it to come back to
you.
And that's what I'm saying. You do your work, you're associating with people, but the gossip or the other things that are happening, the extras, are not going to come back at you because you're doing your work.
I keep telling,
some people gossip without working.
I keep telling people that when you join an organization, the things you need to put into place, understand the vision, mission, values.
Right.
Two, understand the policies.
The policies,
the policies that are going to guide you to work. So
that's if they are policies. You're assuming. Because some of these workplaces,
they don't have policies, if they have, they are not clear.
You know, most organizations that don't have policies are smaller organizations.
Yeah, right.
Now, you find that the work politics is there. It's either this organization is family-based.
Ah, those ones.
So you find that
those ones are hard.
Yes, hey. It is quite hard to fight politics in a family-based organization, your job is to ensure that you get your work done. Talking of getting your work done, managers, since they are the highlights of politics within organizations, one thing they need to know, there are three networks. Like you said, clicks here, clicks there, clicks there. The manager needs to understand, how do I understand the dynamics of these clicks?
And how they work. You need all of them. That
these networks, you need them.
Right.
So how do you need them? You need to identify who in these cliques,
who is the leader?
Operational network.
Which of these the leader,
are the ground leaders?
Who is the strategic network, and what is the developmental network?
Yeah, but
what do I mean? You have your strategic network. The ones that are going, you're going to say, okay guys, find out what analysis, where are the strengths, where are our weaknesses. Go out, understand the business, how it works, you know. And then you find people that have to, these ones that are kalogoi, they have to go.
Yeah,
they want to please networks. Everyone.
But those ones are needed too.
Yes, they are developmental networks. You get them to do this, you get them, and then you have. I mean, those are your operational networks. Then the developmental networks is anyama nyani.
But you see, there's something you forgot. When you talked about vision, mission, whatever. Objectives of the organization, then you talked about policies. You forgot about knowing your job, job description.
You know it,
but you know that some people don't?
Yeah,
because wait a minute.
Because they're trying to
say, do you know why they don't know? Because there are certain workplaces that do not define your JD very well.
They
will tell you that you're late. Mariam, they will tell you that you're here. You're here as a radio broadcaster, and then something else comes up. You find yourself in accounts. You're like, wait a minute.
I thought.
And you know why? Because there's this phrase that is put on your contract.
Any other related.
Assigned duties from time to any other duties.
And you know, most times because you're looking also for don't a job, they will not think
Mariam,
about that last
that
line.
That phrase protects them.
I know.
So for you, is to understand what is in it for me. I need to develop. I need to be better than who I was.
I need to get paid. But haven't you heard of people in organizations where you do the kalogoi work and then the bosses
then
take the... bring the bonus and then the bosses take the bonus.
Yes.
Oh, because
it's all about politics. But also,
the other thing is that people concern themselves with a lot at workplaces. Listen, if I know I'm in a certain department, I'm in the programs department.
Yes.
Who do I need to work with?
Yes.
I have my producer, I have my partner Gaetano, and then I have Suna who does influencing. I need those people to make my work. But I don't need
any
an accountant.
Become ETC.
But yeah, Balala, it's a by the way. I don't really need to over-associate with everyone.
But that's it.
Now those ones, most times they even want to be like in your business. That's why
I don't need to ignore them.
Yeah, you can ignore her, but
when you enter an organization and you have principles that guide you,
exactly,
you understand your job, you know the policies and procedures, you are clear. People don't play around with you.
How you come in also matters. When you come in, they'll step on you, they'll make you do whatever. So you also know you need to come in, go straight, principled, like, you know, I know my job, I know whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So at the end of the day, you focus on what is important to you.
I also,
if the job is not yours, even if you crawl on the floor,
it will not be yours.
It's also nice to know the decision makers. I don't like to waste time with people who don't make the decision.
They're walking in the corridors trying to make you, show you they're important, and they're not important.
So once you know the decision makers, then you know where to go for what.
Yes.
You don't just wonder, and you're not going to be.
You know that has happened a lot in organizations where somebody enters at a low position and finds a manager who says, if you sleep with me in bed, I'm going to give you a job.
I'll get
your promotion.
Right.
You have not understood where does this person lie.
So you think your legs will help
you. So you understand that this person in this environment
is going to help
you. You totally need to understand.
So you're saying sometimes you'll find a woman or man opening legs for the wrong people.
Yes.
So are you saying that they should make sure
that they are the right person?
No, oh my
that
God.
One has killed me. Because they are opening kumbe.
You start saying anytime I'm going to be on a higher position.
Right.
When the pedestal doesn't come, you'll sit
and that's where the managers, most of the leaders misuse power. They want to sleep with, you know.
But if I know I came in on merit, do I have to sleep with
but
you?
Anyone who has slept with someone never lasts in the organization.
Some have excelled.
Others have become wives of somebody in the organization.
Right.
They were strategically.
Yeah.
Thinking on how those I ones
came in
to
came
position.
In with the purpose to use their legs.
Mm-hmm. But just make sure that you tread smart, walk into your workplace, you're confident, you got that job on merit, then
the self-awareness.
Unless you didn't
understand
get it on merit also.
Once you understand who you are, the power that you have as an individual.
Right.
The joy there is in understanding that I know my, job.
Yeah,
I understand
absolutely.
What I'm doing. I know the policies that guide me. No person is going to trickle around you and say, hey, you are this and that. You can put them in their place.
And you
because
cannot...
the workplace politics, you'll hear it in the corridors.
Yeah.
It will never be. And also the other thing is people should stop working in fear. With fear, you're going to lose your job. Why are you...
Like
watching yourself, like
I said,
at the back.
If you actually like, that kind of person, you're the kind they'll tell that sleep and you sleep.
Wake up and you wake up.
Wake
you
up
got
and wake up, sleep with the boss and you'll sleep with the boss. So really,
it is something that organizations also need to embrace, workplace politics.
Right.
In those three dynamisms of you need to understand your networks, your operational network, your strategic network,
your decision makers,
your functional or your developmental network. Because if you know that if I got too lucky, I'll get my job done. She's in a certain department.
Then you go there. You know exactly where to go.
Exactly. So you get your work done. But if you're thinking of so and so knows so they have something going on, you know you're totally.
I don't like in betweens. Decision maker in accounts. Who do I need to see to get my stuff done? Accounts. If I went to another department, that's your friend.
And once you understand your way around the organization, whether you have been fighting the workplace politics and you don't know what to do, it's time. Now you understood that. Now where do I fall? Strategic area where I am?
We shall need the ones
that make decisions, or am I kaloboyi of everyday working?
Actually, but thank you so much. By the way, she's a people's management consultant. You can hire her in case you need any consultancies.
Very well.
Okay, Kakachai, thank you so much for being with us. Till next time.
Bye-bye.